legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up the dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed it deep. That good ship and crew was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As big freighters go, she was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain, Will Caesar. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when she left full loaded for Cleveland. And later that night, when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? As a wave broke over the railing, and every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a time came, the old cook came on deck, saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed you." At 7 p.m., the main hatchway caved in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know you." The captain went in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. Lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they put 15 more miles behind her. They may have split up or they may have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. And all that remains are the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Michigan steams like a young man's dreams, the islands and bays of a sportsman. And further below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can center. And the iron boats go as the mariners all go, the gales of November remember. In a musty old hall in Detroit they prayed, in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa of the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. Superior, they say, never gives up the dead.